What is atrial fibrillation? We asked Dr. Mitchell Faddis, a Washington University cardiac electrophysiologist at Barnes Jewish Hospital, to explain how A-fib occurs.
Atrial fibrillation is a very common condition that affects the heart and causes it to beat irregularly and often very rapidly. It's associated with blood clots that form in the heart and can cause stroke as well as other heart conditions, in particular, heart failure. Atrial fibrillation contributes to about a third of all strokes that occur. The heart is an electrical organ where an electrical signal flows smoothly from the top of the heart down to the bottom.
Atrial fibrillation causes changes in the heart.
Atrial fibrillation tends to form in the left upper chamber or left atrium.
When the pressure on the left atrium is too high, it expands just like a balloon that's overinflated.
The body grows scar tissue into the walls of that chamber to reinforce it and to protect it against further expansion. The problem with the scar tissue is that it's not electrically active, and it works to break up the smooth flow of electricity through the chamber.
Think of a boulder interrupting the flow of water in a stream.
Electrical signals do that in the left atrium and eventually can degenerate into the pattern of electrical fibrillation.
This fibrillation wears the heart cells out and they become weak.
Over time, the cells of that chamber are weakened and become more prone to remain in atrial fibrillation. They become more fragile, pump less blood, and eventually the atrial fibrillation becomes more permanent in the left upper chamber and harder to treat.
Certain conditions increase the risk of AFib, including hypertension, sleep apnea, and diabetes.
Now, hypertension is a condition where the heart has to push against the blood pressure to pump the blood around the body. As a result of that, the muscle in that chamber gets thicker and thicker.
Think of a weightlifter whose muscles get denser in response to their training. Unfortunately, that's not a good thing in the heart.
Sleep apnea is a very common condition where patients repeatedly stop breathing through the night. Those bouts of very high blood pressure happen over and over, and the left atrium experiences the same condition as in hypertension or high blood pressure.
Other conditions that contribute to AFib are diabetes with elevated blood sugar or blood glucose and obesity.
All of these conditions are treatable. By treating the underlying conditions that give rise to atrial fibrillation, we can protect patients.
With an accurate diagnosis, AFib is treatable and normal heart rhythm can be restored. If you think that you or a loved one may be at risk for AFib, visit barnesjewish.org/AFIB to learn more.